shit up, they killed you, like that. And we talking about Smoother Road. Okay, Smoother Road. Hopefully it won't have the popcorn sound. If it does, I apologize. And maybe I'll quit doing the driving VRs. I'll turn down the air a little bit, which may make me sweat a lot. Smoking my Savinelli Virginia. The tobacco's not Virginia. Pipeless. And the last VR I did in my truck as well. And some people may be going, well, why would you smoke in your truck? And again, it's smell like tobacco smoke and ash. Actually, it's not that bad. Now, I do kind of regret smoking the black shag in the truck last time. The room note isn't exactly amazing to my kids and my wife. Tastes great, but the after effects in the truck are not that good. For some reason, in the room, it's not bad. In my office, where I'm allowed to smoke with air purifiers, it's not that bad, but in the truck, in a closed space, it was a pretty bad after effect. So usually what I smoke in the truck, if I do smoke in the truck, is an aromatic, and right now I'm smoking Cornell & Beal's Mocha, which is really, really good, really, really rich. The room note, the truck note, I guess this would be, we got the beard note, we got the bag note, we got the tin note, we got the room note. Wow, I just hit puberty with that room. And now we have the truck note. Mocha leaves it smelling like a coffee shop. So, I'm doing a VR as well to Babyface Huey. And God, I'm hope I get these VRs right, because there's like four I want to do today. And if I get them wrong, y'all can just make fun of me in the comments. But I'm pretty sure Babyface Huey wanted to know what channels we like to watch, what channels have been helpful to us in this pipe smoking hobby, and what tell a tip that helped us out when we first started. One other thing to do when you're driving in the truck and smoking: if you crack the window just a fraction of an inch, it almost creates a little vacuum and sucks the smoke out. So Babyface Huey, my first tip, well, the main tip that helped me a lot, was to slow down, because I was smoking way too fast and I was getting tongue bite. Well, the first few tips I learned about, of course, I was smoking aromatics that will typically bite. The first few tips I learned about, I was trying to fix the tongue bite. So the first one, of course, slow down. And then the other one was, I said it in one of the videos I did, is getting the smoke aimed towards the roof of your mouth. So if this is your tongue here, you want the smoke aimed above the tongue and kind of go across the roof of your mouth and then taste it. That helped a lot getting rid of the tongue bite. As far as channels go, and I do mean this when I say this, I've yet to find a channel I did not like. As far as the YTPC goes. So I'll stick to the channels that helped me the most when I first started. And it's funny, because a lot of you, since I've been in this community, have helped me with your videos along the way. Everybody from you, Babyface Huey, to your nephew Bryce, to Lonnie LL Haynes, Waves of Java. There's been these little mini tips that I pick up from each one of you. But in the beginning, and of course this is due to Google algorithms and how the searches lead you to the more popular channels, etc., etc., with the most views, the most likes. Of course, everybody has seen Mutton Chop Piper. Another one, Gray Bailey, his channel. Got a lot of stuff off of his channel. Not just pipe smoking helpfulness, but grooming, all kinds of cool stuff. I think he may be a life coach. If he's not, he needs to be. As far as tobaccos and pipes, tobacco pipe collector. One recently, I didn't realize he had a channel until after I bought one of his pipes, is Morgan Pipes. Really good channel. There's some good info on there. And then there was some random, when I first got into it, when you get into a hobby, sometimes you dive in head first. Some people just kind of dabble in it, and then it grows on them. I dive in head first. I bought like chunks of briar to try to make my own. I'm not an artist. I'm horrible at it. And they're good smoking pipes, but they're ugly. Maybe one day I'll show a couple of them. And bought all those estate pipes. Gonna try to finish them. Kind of like I'm doing that one for the giveaway. I'm gonna trick those out. I'm not necessarily an artist, but I can kind of take ideas and concepts and put them into something. I just can't come up with them off the top of my head. And plus, I thought, hey, it's kind of a waste that these pipes are just gonna sit here unsmoked. I'd probably end up smoking them eventually, but nobody's gonna buy them. But they're good smokers. I'll check them out. Pimp my pipe. I'm not gonna put stereo systems in them or neon lights. Those are the channels that have helped the most, but like I said, every single one of you that I've subscribed to, that I've watched your videos, have been great. Found a new one today with Bearded Bristol's giveaway. Ghost Cobb, had never seen his channel, found it, liked it, subscribed to it. So that is my VR to Babyface Huey. And he is giving away some awesome pipes. If you have not done a VR to him, he's giving away, like I said a minute ago, the Morgan Bones pipes. Amazing pipes. Keep your pipes loaded, slow down, philosophize, and enjoy your life. See you guys.